The quaternion formulation comes from the Euler axis formulation and is simply a change of variables from that formulation. So what we're going to do is define an E0, EX, EY, EZ. These are four components that define this quaternion, and those are defined or related to the Euler axis according to this here. So E0 is equal to cosine of theta, capital theta over 2. Remember, that's the rotation angle in the Euler axis formulation. EX is capital EX times sine of theta over 2. EY is the little EY is equal to capital EY times sine of theta over 2, and EZ, little EZ is equal to capital EZ times sine of theta over 2. Okay, so this is just a change of variables. Notice that this is all the information from the Euler axis, and we're just doing this change of variables into these four components over here, which are called the quaternion. Now, this formulation is sometimes called the Euler-Rodriguez quaternion, or these four parameters are sometimes called the Euler-Rodriguez symmetric parameters, and that's because both Euler and Rodriguez contributed to this formulation. And anyway, there's quite a bit of history for how this all came about, but anyway, we're not going to go into the history. You can look that up in different books and papers, and we're just going to focus here on the math and how this works together to define the orientation of the aircraft. Okay, so the first thing let's look at is, again, we have four components, which means that we need one more relationship. Remember, orientation can be defined by using only three components. So we have one redundancy relation here that we need to develop. And so traditionally, what we say is that we look at E0 squared plus EX squared plus EY squared plus EZ squared. Okay, so if we work that out and go back to what their definitions are, E0 squared is equal to cosine squared of theta over 2. And then EX squared plus EY squared plus EZ squared, notice that they all have a sine theta inside of those. So I'm going to pull that out. I'm going to say that it's equal to EX squared plus EY squared plus EZ squared times sine squared of theta over 2. And from the Euler axis formulation, remember this was, we said that that had a unit length. So that's equal to 1. And so if we plug that in now, we've got cosine squared plus sine squared, which is also equal to 1. Okay, so this is our redundancy relation, is that the length of this, of the quaternion, is equal to 1. Okay, so that's... So we're going to use that in our flight simulator and make sure that the length of the quaternion remains at 1 in order to mitigate some of the error that can build up by integrating the quaternion forward in time. Okay, so so now to develop the quaternion formulation, what we need to do is come back to this Euler's formula that we looked at previously in the Euler axis formulation. And we had this transformation that would take us from earth fixed to body fixed. And of course, the transpose or the inverse of this matrix will take us in the opposite direction. And so now with these definitions down here, we can actually take these this formulation here and just plug it directly into this equation. And there's a bunch of trigonometric identities that you apply and simplification. And after doing all that, I'm not going to work through the math, but after doing all of that, you get this result here. So this is the transformation now using the quaternion to go from earth fixed coordinates to body fixed coordinates. And of course, you could go the opposite direction, body fixed to earth fixed, by using the transpose or the inverse of this matrix, which are the same thing, because it's a proper orthogonal matrix. Okay, so so again, if we wanted to figure out the weight vector in the body fixed coordinate system, we know what it is in the earth fixed coordinate system. It's always pointing towards the center of the earth. So we could use this transformation. If we know the components of the quaternion, these four components, then we can figure out what the weight vector is in the body fixed coordinate system. Now, before I go on, I want to mention that this labeling here, this is what we're going to use throughout this course for labeling these components. E naught is related to the scalar rotation angle of the Euler axis formulation. And then EX, EY, and EZ are related to the components of the Euler axis components, you know, EX, EY, EZ, or capital EX, EY, EZ. So this is kind of seen as the scalar component, and then these are seen as the vector components of the quaternion. And this labeling is by no means universal. Some people label these 1 through 4 with subscripts 1 through 4. Some of them even do it in descending order instead of ascending order. Some people use 0, 1, 2, 3. Anyway, there's a bunch of different ways that these are labeled. And so it's important to just recognize when you're looking through another book or through some publication that this labeling has been, you know, different labels have been used by different people. And so you just want to make sure that you understand what their labeling convention is and how it matches or how it compares to the labeling convention that we're going to use here. Okay. So here we have this transformation that we've developed to go from the earth fixed to body fixed, and we can use it to go the opposite direction by using the transpose or the inverse. And now what we need to know is what is the change in this quaternion as a function of time, right? And so we could take the derivative of this, and we get the derivative of this by simply differentiating this. So we can take the change in the Euler axis formulation as a function of time. So anyway, you could take the derivative of this and then plug that information into, remember this is the change in the Euler axis with respect to time related to P, Q, and R. So that's related to the rotation rates on board the aircraft. And so if we take this information here that's related to these changes and plug it into the derivative of this with respect to time and rearrange, and again, I'm not going to work through the math, but if you work through that, what we get is this for the change in the quaternion as a function of time, and that depends on the rotation rates on board the aircraft P, Q, and R, and the current quaternion. So these two, these equations here, so this is our transformation equation up here, and then this is our change in our quaternion with respect to time. These are going to be integral to our flight simulator because we will be using this quaternion formulation. So basically, if we can figure out the quaternion at the beginning of the simulation, then we can figure out the change in quaternion with time from this equation here. So at each time step, we'll be integrating this equation forward in time to get the change in our quaternion. And at any point in time, we can then we can compute the components of one vector in earth fixed or body fixed and compute over to the body fixed or earth fixed in the other coordinate system. So now a couple things I want to point out. This equation here, this is our change in quaternion with respect to time. This is much faster than what we get from the Euler angle formulation or direction cosine formulation. Notice that we're just computing four components. So we're computing the change in four components with respect to time. We're integrating this forward in time. With the direction cosine, we're integrating nine components forward in time. And so that requires quite a bit more computational, expense for the computer, and then if you compare it to the Euler angle formulation, this matrix here has a bunch of sines and cosines in it for the Euler angle formulation. And sines and cosines require quite a bit of time actually for a computer to compute compared to, these are just numbers here. These are just all real numbers in here. And so we're just multiplying this matrix by this vector with real numbers and getting the change in the quaternion. So anyway, this represents quite a significant speed up. So these computations can happen very rapidly, which is beneficial for flight simulation. Now, the one drawback to the quaternion formulation is that when we look at these numbers, you know, these are each just a real number, or EX, EY, EZ, or the change in those. These are just real numbers. And when we look at those, we don't have a real intuitive sense of the orientation of the aircraft. And that's different than the Euler angle formulation, where we get out phi, theta, and psi as the numbers. And so we can look at those angles. You know, we're usually computing that in radians, but we can switch that to degrees and very quickly imagine the orientation of the aircraft. But based off of the numbers here for the Euler, for the quaternion formulation, these values for these components here are very difficult to have a gut feel for the orientation of the aircraft. So eventually, when we feed information back to the pilot or back to a display, we're going to want to take the quaternion information and compute it back to something that's more intuitive, like an elevation angle and a bank angle and an azimuth angle for display to the pilot or for other users of the simulator. Okay, so this wraps up the quaternion formulation or introduction to this quaternion formulation. Now, one of the things that's really awesome about the quaternion formulation is that there's a whole world of mathematics built around quaternions. And so you're probably familiar with scalar mathematics. And so I'll just write these down. We have scalar mathematics, and we have vector mathematics, and you're probably well aware of those. For example, with scalars, we have plus, minus, multiplication, and divide, and many other operators. With vectors, we have like dot products and cross products and addition as well that you can do with vectors. And there's a whole world of mathematics for quaternions, which is a four-component representation of some, it's a mathematical construct with four components, and it actually has a scalar component and a vector component. So we're going to find that the quaternion mathematics is really helpful to understand how to manipulate these quaternions here, and we'll be applying those in our flight simulator.